Everything for Zoom events happens in the events portal. So separate from Zoom.us, events.zoom.us. Let's go through the create event process from scratch. Big blue button, create event, brings me as a Zoom events license holder. In this case, if you're a Zoom sessions holder, a lot of this applies with a few differences. You won't have as many event template options here. We provide four curated templates to get you started. And especially for those of you who are brand new, it's well worth your time to spend some time going through what these templates look like and understanding what a marketing showcase recommended set of settings might be like. So I'm going to create an event from a blank state. And already I'm offered one of the many flexible options here, which is my event type. We're going to talk about multi-session event. This allows you to do up to 6 days of live content. This does not have to be consecutive days. These can be spread out sometimes even over months if you would so desire. Let's title this one. I'm going to call this Zoom into the future of hybrid. We're not going to publish this one. I've already built out a demo. We'll go look at that in a second. But date and time, very simple to do. Let's look for a December 1st event. Time this all. Here's where I can add all of the live event days that I want to add, up to 6. I can add all of those here and get sort of my basic event configuration done before I enter into the build process. Time zone. This is a big frequently asked question. This time zone relates to the builder experience. So this is sort of your time zone. Zoom events does display the localized time for all of your users throughout their experience. Main event image, this is the first opportunity for me to leverage the content library. So here I can navigate in, find an appropriate session visual. Let's use this beautiful photo from Zoomtopia last year. Note, I can kind of pick and choose pieces of it, kind of crop the image depending on what you want it to look like and bring that right in. Again, haven't really even gone to the full flow. This is all before I even get the event fully created. Next, we offer sort of three types of attendee experiences. You can use Zoom events to take registration and deliver attendee experiences for virtual, hybrid, or even in-person only attendees now. By default, there is a registration link. This is the most common use case, is I'm doing a public event and I want to take registration and give people a join link. Once you have that all filled out, now you're ready to hit save and continue. I'm gonna do so, and then we're gonna jump over to the template. Event branding is very, very cool. This tends to be one of the most fun parts of a demo and probably for you even playing around with it. But a couple things I'll point out here on the event branding page. We do have a what is it? That's very cool to kind of help you understand and navigate the tool, especially early. Color templates. Right here, I can understand the 6 colors that are being leveraged throughout this event and can right here just set my 6 colors and start to see what it does. We also have provided 5 various color templates to get you started, along then with I can go in and then edit color by color to maybe bring my brand right into it. Once I've sort of established my overall color template, then I can go through piece by piece and begin to define colors for various elements. Maybe once you've done the color template, you're done. Or maybe you really want to see and understand how the font works and so on and so forth. We give you previews, we give you a mobile preview, and you can go moment by moment and piece by piece through your event. Kind of the hottest and funnest part is being able to upload that background. Max video length is 60 seconds with a max file size of 10 megabits. So that information is all right here. You can bring in an image or a video. And we also offer this as a super, super cool feature. I have brought in this 30-second video. It's kind of a cool moving gradient with a square kind of built into it. I get a preview here. And we also have this really lovely overlay feature. So I'm gonna turn it off. This shows you what the original video that I brought in looks like. But I can also toggle on. I add in one of our blue colors. So here in the color overlay, I can do things like bring in my own brands and maybe I wanna use the same video over and over again. I do often. I can kind of shade it to my different things. Maybe I want it to look a little darker or a little more orange, so on and so forth.